Hey there, how are you doing? This is Kali from TechFanciers. So in our last video, we have installed the AirOS Android 12.1 on our Realme Pad, and I was continuously using it for a few days, and here are my quick and detailed thoughts. So let's take an in-depth look. Long story short, I like this one. I actually feel it is a good upgrade from my old stock Android 11. Not the best or fulfilled, but when compared to the stock Android 11 with the quick switch glitch, it is better. Does it mean you also can install? Well, let's find out. This ROM is built by Nail and running with 5th July 2022 security patch with the kernel version 4.14. Starting with boot animation, it is minimal, just a get filled in and makes the boot. I hate the weird text when we turn the device on, but that is nothing to do with the custom ROM. We'll see if we are able to install any splash screen and change it. Then comes to the home screen. Well, it is pure Android 12 experience. Android 12 L has special functionalities for tablets, like this bottom tab to switch the apps, which comes in handy to switch between apps flawlessly, which I miss in the old Realme UI Android 11. This dual setting menu pattern in right or left corner based on the swiping up, status bar, right handed nav bar, everything makes it better than before. I have inserted my GeoSIM and memory card, both are working fine. VoLTE is working and I am able to make calls and receive messages. Let's talk about performance. Performance wise, there is no loss. Actually, it is somewhat better than Realme UI Android 11. I don't have the old Android 11's Geekbench score, but when I searched in Google and compared it with other Realme Android 11 score like TechRadar's one, it is actually somewhat 50 points higher, where the multi-core is 1286. When I run it in our Arrow, it is 1332, which is not much, but somewhat this ROM is not making any performance loss. So that is really appreciable. I also ran the stress test for 10 minutes straight and the level is managed well and there isn't much drop. I also played Apex Legends in normal graphics, high frame rate and realistic color profile. The FPS always stayed like 25 to 30 in entire gameplay. Of course, the loading screen had some glitch, but the gameplay was fully smooth. I played it for half an hour, one entire match. So there is no issue with that. It still it looks like stable in terms of graphics oriented thing.
Opening fire. Reloading.
Battery and charging, well, it is normal as stock Android 11, there isn't any problem. From 11 PM to next day 11 AM, it only consumed 1%, which is good. Audio wise, it is still great. All 4 quad speakers are firing like earlier. There isn't a Dolby Atmos or something like that, which we had in Android 11, but we have some sort of normal equalizer to play around. Which is actually fine. Audio jack and Bluetooth headphones are working fine, no complaint on that. Camera wise, it is fine. Actually, some pictures are seems better than normal our Android 11. I am not concentrating much on it as it is fine to take Zoom calls or Google Meet. I did install the camera to API checker and the level of support is full. I think this one also supports the functionalities, but I am unable to find a working Gcam for it. If anyone have any working Gcam for Realme Pad, please let me know in the comments. Security wise, I tested SafetyNet and it passes all the criteria. I even tried banking apps, it worked fine. Storage wise, it is not encrypted, so you should be able to view the internal storage and install any sort of packages in the TWRP. Next, what? Functionalities, features, performance, stability, gaming, audio, camera and security all are covered. So what left? Well, only demerits and problems. See, before proceeding with that, I have to clear that this ROM is really good and looks stable as far as my usage on past few days. So problem are just nitpicking here and there, which doesn't affect much of your day-to-day things, just a common things which I have noticed when using it. First thing is features and customization. I am unable to find any customization or features tab where I can play around the things. I desperately wanted to enable the network monitor indicator, which is not there in this Aero OS. This part is also not there in our earlier Android 11, so you don't feel any difference, but our old Android 11 had the face unlock, which works perfectly fine, whereas here we don't have it. We have a PIN, pattern and password, no face unlock. Second thing is some sort of visual jittering effect in home screen where the frame skips or where the frame just constantly skips or happening when we move the screens. It is not only in home screen, but I feel some minor lags in visual in terms of producing the visual animations when watching the YouTube video in 4K or 2K 60fps. I feel some sort of lagness. I thought I am the only one feeling it as I am using 90Hz display phone as my daily driver, but when I checked with some fellow users who is using Aero OS, they also confirmed the same, that they have facing some sort of lagness in home screen and frame skips in the visuals and animations. Also, I have noticed that the device is not keeping carrier aggregation on. I did install the Netmonster and checked the log. The network just connected to a single band, and where else in my Note 11 the device connected to two bands simultaneously. I believe earlier it was working in Android 11. But still, these are just so minute things which you will forget once you get used to it. I didn't face any major bugs like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, audio, volte, mic or display related things. Those things are well solid, which makes me to stick with this ROM until something else comes. So that's what about this review. If you faced any other issue that I missed here, please mention in the comment section, which will help others to decide whether they can go with this or not. We can build this community together by helping each other. And I request you guys to join our TechFanciers Telegram community and discuss multiple technology trends and stuffs. I even made a giveaway, but sad thing is we don't even have people to entirely fulfill the participation. That's funny, but yeah, anyway, thank you for watching. KOTMTO.